Welcome to our thought for today, for Tuesday the 5th of May. I hope you've had a chance to read the psalm and the reading in Acts and the reading in John. Our psalm today gives us an image of dwelling with God in the place of worship. It speaks of passing through the springs of water. The temple area was fed by an underground spring of water, feeding its trees in the courtyards and its individual baptism pools called the mikveh, that all worshippers use to be cleansed from dusty travel and then come up into the place of worship clean. God loves to be with us in the place of worship, the place of living spring water. Today that is not a geographical place. That place today is in our lives and so in our homes. Where we are, he is with us. Jesus the gate is the protector. Jesus as the good shepherd is the provider. He provides for the sheep and knows them all by name. A shepherd knows his sheep, and so he knows you. You can recognise his voice. There's a great story told by a vicar once in Oxford called David McInnes, whose father had been bishop in Jerusalem. The story goes that a Palestinian farmer's sheep were stolen, and so the farmer decided to go to the great market where the sheep are auctioned on a weekly basis to see if he could find them. Once he had arrived, he went round all the pens, calling out his sheep by name. And sure enough, they were there. They were found as they responded to him. The lost sheep were found because the shepherd and the sheep knew each other by name and voice. The shepherd goes out to call his sheep home. They will flourish best with him. In Acts, the reading today, we see how Barnabas becomes a good shepherd himself. As believers in Jesus were dispersed by the persecution that came after the death of Stephen, they went to a number of places north of Israel and also across the water to Cyprus. They shared the news that Jesus is Lord and Messiah with many other Jews they met, and those men and women became believers. However, nobody at this point went to the Gentiles until a few from Cyprus and Cyrene went to the Gentiles living in Antioch, preached to them, and they became believers. Barnabas was wisely sent to Antioch to help them grow in faith, and he brought with him Saul from Tarsus. Barnabas is a very good example of one of Jesus' shepherds. He is a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and faith. He sees the need for shepherds to care for the new believers, and he is not shy of asking others to come and help. And for a whole year, they taught the believers and helped them to worship. They also enabled them to understand the need of giving, so that at one point this young church was able to send financial gifts to those suffering in Jerusalem. These Gentile believers in Antioch became known as Christians, a term that is like a nickname. They were called Little Christs. They were seen to be like Jesus. So let us today go to be with God in his place of worship, following our good shepherd and learning from him, and in turn share that learning with others to encourage them in their spiritual growth and life, to be like Barnabas, to be like Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit and of faith.